Good evening. Much of the northern river city of Lismore is underwater tonight. Its worst flooding on record, completely breaching its protective levee, with locals forced to scramble onto rooftops. 500 flood rescues have been conducted, with efforts underway tonight to reach hundreds more people still trapped in their homes. Extreme weather warnings remain in place across the state's northeast, with an extraordinary 775 millimetres of rain falling in the worst hit region. Lismore's Wilson's River has peaked above 14 metres, its highest level since records began. The result? Devastating, bringing heartbreak and heroism as rescuers in tinnies formed a highway of hope on the water.
All day they came and went, so many boats that other volunteers were turned away and they were carrying precious cargo.
We've lost heaps except for what we've got on our backs and in our hands.
And what is in your hands is pretty important.
Yes.
Just like so many families, they were stranded in floodwaters for more than 12 hours.
I just can't describe it, yeah.
The young, the old.
Are you okay, ma'am?
I have tanked them.
Their children and their pets.
It's shaky.
You're 83 years old?
Yeah.
You've never seen anything like this?
No, never.
Not for any of his 83 years. In fact, not since records began in 1870 has Lismore been swamped like this. The 1974 record was just over 12 metres. Today, it pushed past 14.
It's 74. You got about 2 foot of water under the house.
2.5, 3 foot.
This is 2.5 metres up the house.
SES volunteers are exhausted.
Our town, our home, just gone.
The lady just said her house washed away. I feel devastated for these poor people.
Evacuations began 2 a.m. An hour later, the levee would burst, Lismore was going under, and the SES would receive hundreds of calls from in and around this small northern town.
Our house is up on stilts down there. About 5 o'clock, it went from about the mailbox all the way up. Everything's gone.
When no rescue could be done by water, it was done by air. Because helicopters were the only way of plucking evacuees from rooftops.
There's 26 of us on the roof waiting to be rescued.
Lakeside Lodge is part of a lake now, and for motel guests, there was nowhere to go but up and nothing to do but wait wet.
As you can see, all our cars are now destroyed.
We've got 4 houses in a row with people trapped in attics.
I'm on my roof. The water's still rising. My dog is stuck inside my house.
Something I've never ever seen in my life.
Nobody alive has.
What we are seeing today is unprecedented.
From the Rural Fire Service helicopter, you see street after street submerged, more in the south than the north, homes and businesses destroyed and uninsured. The cost of premiums living on a floodplain is astronomical. This is how Lismore looked at 12 metres in 1954. It will always look like this at some stage when La Niña comes to town.
There wasn't enough time for this water due to the 2 La Niñas in a row to be released, to be ejected into the ocean. We have a higher probability of flooding.
There is a lag effect with all this extraordinary rain, with the high mountain ranges around Lismore. It's going to keep on falling into the township over the coming days as we see rescue after rescue after rescue. The rain is simply relentless, more than 700 mil since last Wednesday, and it's anticipated a further 150 will fall by midnight tonight.
We have seen to date over 500 flood rescues. We've had 927 requests for assistance over the last 24 hours. The conditions are expected here in New South Wales to get worse.
That is bad news for other northern New South Wales towns yet to evacuate and bracing for the fury that has rained down on Lismore. There is moderate flooding in Grafton, where the Clarence River could reach 7.5 metres this evening. Homes and shop fronts are being sandbagged. For those with nowhere to go, an evacuation at Southern Cross University and hospitality from the salvos.
I don't really have any relatives that I can go to that aren't also flooded.
The boys here, girls, doing a great job. Very welcoming.
And let's go live to Robert Ovadia, now on board with a rescue crew in Lismore. Rob, how many more people are still waiting to be rescued this evening?
Good evening, Mark. Well, it's certainly in the hundreds. We have heard a number as high as 400, although that is certainly yet to be confirmed. In the past hour or so, an army helicopter has been doing laps of here, I guess, essentially looking for anybody who might still be stuck on a rooftop. So at least they get a visual from the air. But the concern right now is for the elderly, those who are not strong enough necessarily to get onto a rooftop, who might be cowering perhaps in an attic or on the top floor, and maybe even too weak or even too scared or confused to call out to rescuers. So the number is thought to be 400. There is a degree of good news, however, in that this is thought to have peaked right now as we go to air at 14.37 metres. That means anybody who currently is above that waterline will be safe, even if they have an uncomfortable stay tonight.
Yeah, let's hope they stay safe through the night. Rob, thank you. Also in Lismore, Seven's Bill Hogan, who's been on the go since the early hours of this morning and has been caught up in some astonishing flood rescues. Bill, you've witnessed extraordinary scenes.
Yeah, we certainly have, Mark. We were evacuated from our motel this morning around 2 a.m. when news had broken that the levee bank was about to breach. From daybreak, we were keen to see the extent of the floodwater, so my cameraman Henry Lynch and I hitched a ride with a rescue boat with a plan to go and pick up some people stranded on the Elliott's Road bridge over the Wilson's River. But it was there the unexpected happened. Ours was among a flotilla of small craft heading east, somewhere over the Bruxner Highway.
That was a low one.
Going live to Seven's morning show, ducking power lines.
That's what we're dealing with at the moment, Larry and Kylie, so excuse me if I keep watching my head.
The Wilson's River at 14 metres, up ahead a bridge just above water. Dozens eager to be taken off.
We're just arriving at the bridge now where a lot of people are waiting to be rescued.
A traffic jam of volunteers. Then off to one side, an emergency. Rescuers needing rescue.
We're just being alerted. There's a tinny's just been flipped over and people have been washed away.
Two people struggling to stay afloat.
And they're in real trouble out there. That water is moving up to 10 knots, maybe more.
Clinging desperately to power lines, thankfully not live.
We're going to stay with you, Bill. That's a very difficult rescue to effect.
The SES volunteers are rushing out there now. They're just calling out for some more help. This is the danger and we're seeing it unfold right now.
But those in the water too exhausted to clamber aboard.
They're in real trouble here. The person probably hasn't got enough energy pull themselves up.
A ski boat bringing an inflatable tube.
There's a donut there, so there's a few more hands on deck.
But the pair still in real danger of drowning.
Just doesn't have enough strength to get up. As you can see, he's just got nothing left here.
After 10 minutes, one is dragged into the ski boat.
So scared.
The other man clutching the bow of another boat.
That's as dangerous as it gets, somebody hanging onto the front of an outboard engine boat.
Finally, delivered safely.
Real heroics from everyone involved there.
Our mission, this elderly couple, cold, wet, exhausted.
Let's get you on board.
His wife made it. 86-year-old John struggling with arthritic hips.
That's your leg.
That's it.
There you go.
Forced to abandon their home 56 years, but happy to have hitched a ride.
It's worth more money, mate.
Yeah.
What do I say about that?
Mate, do you want to come to Sydney with me?
The real heroes, people like our skippers, boaties and fishermen risking their lives.
As you saw before, that tinny just went straight over.
The conditions too dangerous for small boats.
There certainly needs to be more resources because a lot of this reliance is on the people here to try and help other people, and that's where, you know, if this wasn't the case, it would be certainly a different story.
And as we saw, a story almost with a tragic ending. In Lismore, Bill Hogan, 7 News.
Now in Queensland, the death toll has risen with 8 people confirmed dead after what has been described as a weather event never seen before. More than 15,000 homes in Brisbane are underwater, thousands of people still stranded after parts of the Sunshine State recorded a year's worth of rain in just a few days.
If you've ever been to Brisbane, today you'd struggle to get your bearings.
We accepted the risks, but in all honesty, we didn't expect
the levels to come up this high again.
Dozens of flood-prone suburbs submerged, an emergency response now in full swing.
The army's great and the police have been great. You should always be grateful for them.
While the Brisbane River's height isn't record-breaking, the rainfall has been.
We haven't seen this amount of rain in 3 days since 1840.
500 mils in 24 hours, causing a catastrophe likened to the last flood disaster.
Deja vu, 2011, that's our second time.
It wasn't meant to happen again.
The city's landmarks are swamped, so too 15,000 homes.
Evacuated our house at Graceville and moved too. I can't do it. It's too much.
Did the house has gone under?
Yeah. Yep.
Hundreds of businesses and several schools are also underwater.
My precious school's now flooded.
The river so powerful, it threatened to topple a crane on a barge that broke free. These houseboats hopefully unoccupied.
Hold on to your heart.
A lot of what's ending up in Brisbane came from here, the Bremer River, 40 kilometres west at Ipswich, another city going under.
This area is completely cut off by floodwater. The only way to get in here is by boat.
Thousands of people evacuated from homes. Some of these properties had been raised after the 2011 flood, not high enough.
How's it feel now you've seen it?
Sydney. This is probably the politest way to use.
On the Gold Coast, flash flooding claimed the lives of a man and his dog.
We are following that system as it leaves a trail of destruction or an inland sea across the coast.
Even the canals can't keep up.
Now there could be sharks in your garden.
Defence troops, their helicopters are on standby, having already saved several lives, but this flood has proved anyone can be a hero.
There he is.
Hey! Good job!
In the sodden sunshine state, every little win is worth celebrating. Tom Hartley, 7 News.
As that weather system moves south, there are concerns. Parts of Sydney could also flood. Serena Andaloro is at Warragamba Dam this evening. Serena, authorities are so worried they've just held crisis talks.
Yes, Mark, and more rain in the catchment here, not good news. I can tell you the SES Commissioner, bosses from the Bureau of Meteorology and Water New South Wales bosses met this afternoon. They are anxiously watching Warragamba Dam. On Wednesday, a major spill is expected. Controlled releases are currently underway in preparation. 7 News understands flood-prone areas like Windsor and Richmond could be affected again. The flooding is also expected along the Georges River, which could impact suburbs in the southwest. While it's likely the flooding won't reach levels seen last year when so many areas along the Hawkesbury went under, the rain forecast over the next few days is very vague, so the situation could quickly turn, Mark.
OK, Serena, thank you. With the very latest on that, Angie Asimus is here. Ange, what's the situation now?
Well, Mark, it is going to be another dangerous night. This system has been described as a rain bomb, and this is what that looks like on the radar. It has been relentless with more than a metre of rain across southeast Queensland and northeast New South Wales over the past week. But the warning area has shifted in the last hour. Instead of the north coast, it's now the Hunter, Metro, Illawarra and south coast. And this is why our model shows that low deepening out in the Tasman tonight, then drifting southwards parallel to the coast tomorrow, potentially even approaching the central and south coast again by Wednesday. These are the totals we are expecting over the next 3 days alone. Lots of blue around Sydney showing 50 to 100 millimetres. I'll have an update on this situation soon, Mark.